mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ο Κυριός, Άγιος ο Πάνωτος, ελέησον ημάς. Δόξα πατρίν και Υιόν και Υιό Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐν και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Παναγία Τριάς, ελέησον ημάς. Κύριε Λάστα τας αμαρτίας ημών. Δέσποτα συγχώρης τας αμαρτίας ημών. Άγιε επίσκεψε και είστε τας ασθενείας ημών. Ενή και το όνοματό σου. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον. Δόξα πατρίν και Υιόν και Υιό Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐν και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Πάτερ ημών, ο Έλληνος ουρανής, αγιαστείτο το όνομά σου, ενθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθείτο το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανών και επί της γης, τον άρτον ημών των επίλου σου, δώσε μην σήμερα, και άφεσε μην τα οφειλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήντους οφειλέτες ημών, και εμείς εν έγιση ημάς εις πειρασμών, αλλά είσαι ημάς από τον Κύριο. Lift it up on the cross by your free will. Christ God, bring mercy to the new commonwealth that bears your name. Grant our faithful rulers by your power, giving them victory over their everything service. May you alliance be for them a weapon for peace and invisible standard. Now and always and forever and ever. Amen. And also an unfaithful protector, do not spurn our supplications. Gracious and all praise to your Theotokos. Uphold the Orthodox commonwealth, preserve those who are called to govern. Grant them victory from on high, for you, the only blessed one, gave birth to God.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray to you, dear Son, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our treasure.
Forsake me not, stay not far from me, hasten to help me, O Lord of my salvation. shall be filled as with joyous prayer and joyful lips will praise your name. As I lay on my couch, I remember you. From that day I look throughout the earth watches, that you become for me the humble one, that in the shelters of your wings I will find delight. My soul clings to you, and your right hand holds me up. But as for those who sought my life in vain, may they sink into the depths of the earth, and be given up with the sword, the prayer of jackals they should be. But the king shall rejoice in God, and all who swear by him shall glory, for the mouth of liars is stopped. I meditate on you throughout the earth and watches, that you become for me the heavenly one, but in the shelters of your wings I will find delight. My soul clings to you, and your right hand holds me up. Δόξα πατρικείων και ιδιοπνεύματι και νίκια είναι και εις τους αιώνες των αιώνων. Αμήν. Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα στον Θεό. Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον, Κύριε Λέησον. Δόξα πατρικείων και ιδιοπνεύματι και νίκια είναι και εις τους αιώνες των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ο Θεός που σωτηρία μου, η μέρα με έκαψε και νύχτα με αντίωσε. Let my prayer reach out to you, let your ear to my plea, O Lord, for my soul is full of trouble. My life in close days. I was wrecked with those who fell down to the pit. I was like a man beyond help left for dead. Like the slain left to lie in the grave, those who remember no more, for they're cut away from your hand. You have cast me down to the deepest darkness, the darkness and the shadows of death. Your anger was a burden upon me. You poured your billows over me. You took my friends away from me. You made me loathsome to them. I was closed in and could not escape. My eyes were redeemed with distress. I cried out to you, O Lord, all the day. I stretched out my hands to you. What would you work wonders for the dead? Or can physicians raise them up to sing your praise? Does anyone sing you love in the grave or truthfulness in the midst of prediction? Are you marvels that are known in the darkness or your justice in the land of rebellion? And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, and to you my prayer shall rise at dawn. Why, O Lord, do you reject my prayer? Why do you hide your face away from me? I am wrapped in trouble since my youth. I was raised high and humble and distressed. Your plagues have swept over me, and your terrors have left shaken. They surround me like waters all the day, they close in upon me from all sides. You have distanced me from friends and neighbors, and my crying is a right to mine. O Lord God of my salvation, day and night I cried out before you. Let my prayer reach up to you, let your ear to my request, O Lord. Bless the Lord of my soul, may all that is blessed his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul, and forget not how he gives from him, who pardons all your sins and heals all your burdens, who ransoms your life from corruption and grows to his love and mercies, who fills you long as what is good, and your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord performs deeds of the kindness and medication for all the oppressed. He has made known his ways to Moses and his will to Israel children. The Lord is the one of compassion and mercy, long suffering and manifold love. Condensed not forever, but when his anger always lasts. He has not dealt with us as our sins demand, nor does he repay our evil deeds. For as high as the heavens stand over the earth, so far as the Lord extends his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our sins from us. As kind as a father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself knows well how we perform, remembers we are only made of dust. A man whose days resembles grass, as a flower of the field so shall he bloom. But let a breeze pass over him and his God, and never shall know his place again. But the love of the Lord is from all eternity, to all eternity for those who fear him. And his justice upon the children of children, from those who keep his kind and remember his laws to obey them. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, over all things his kingdom is supreme. Bless the Lord with his angels, whose strong and mighty ones obey his word on hearing the sound of his decree. Bless the Lord whose power and thankful to obey his will. Bless the Lord whose works in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord of my soul. Bless the Lord of my soul in every place of his dominion. O Lord, hear my prayer and truthful to keep to my plea, and your righteousness answer me. And enter not into judgment with your servant, since all the living not in judgment your side. The enemy has hunted me down. He has crushed my life into the ground. He has forced me to live in darkness like those who own death. My spirit fades with grief, and within me my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old, and meditate on all your deeds, and ponder the works of your hands. I stretch out my hand to you, like a parched land, my soul thirsts for you. Make haste to answer me, Lord. My spirit has failed. Turn my face away from me, lest I be like those in the pit. Grant that I may hear you steadfast love of God. For I placed my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I lifted up my soul to you. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies. It is you that I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May human spirits keep me on a straight path. For the sake of your name, O Lord, you will keep me alive. In your righteousness, you deliver me from affliction. In your love and kindness, you destroy my enemies and bring to all those who oppose me, for I am your servant. O Lord, hear my prayer, the truth must be to my being, your righteous answer. May human spirits keep me on a straight path. Dox a patrique iom que dio plena, que mique a in que su sona sona alma. Amin. Alleluia, 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 dox a shadows. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 dox a shadows, altissimo, qui vie dox a si.
Oh,
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. rose from the tomb, O Savior, O powerful, and Hades beheld the marvel and was struck with fear, and the dead were rising up, and creation beholds and rejoiced with you, and Adam is also exalted, O my Savior, and the world ever sings your praise. You are the light of those in darkness. You are the resurrection of all, and the life of mortals. And with yourself you resurrected everyone, O Savior, destroying the dominion of death and smashing the gates of Hades, O Word. The mortals, beholding the miracle, marvel, and all creation rejoices in your resurrection, O lover of mankind. Therefore, we all glorify and exalt your compensation. O my Savior, and the world ever sings your praise. A disciple who became of the divine world, and with Paul the choice one, you led the world into the light and drove the darkness of ignorance away by writing the gospel of Christ our God. As a beloved physician and disciple of Luke, with mystical surgery, heal the passion of my soul and body alike. And when you do enjoy complete health, may I joyously honor your solemn feast and shower your holy and all-honored body with tears instead of perfume. And it is an engraved monument of life in the marvelous Church of the Apostles. And it proclaims to all, as you did before when you wrote it, the gospel of Christ our God. On October 18th, we commemorate the Holy Apostle, the Evangelist Luke. On this day, we also commemorate the Holy Mother, Marinos the Elder. On this day, we also commemorate the devoted Father, Julian of the Ephraites. On this day, St. Massin, Bishop of Cyprus, and the Holy 40 children died by the sword. Today, we also commemorate the whole newly appeared martyrs, Gabriel and Kibidonis, who contested an angel in the year 1522. We also commemorate our devoted fathers, Simeon and Theodore, and the devoted women, Ephrosyne, who founded the holy icon, the Mother of God, and started the monastery at the Great Cave. By their holy intercession of God, have mercy on us. Amen.
Establish your servants who exalt you, O Lord.
resurrection. For having endured the cross for us, he destroyed death by death. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the abundance of your compassion. Blot out my transgressions, wash me thoroughly from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin, for I know my wickedness, and my sin is always before me. Against you Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
purpose, that you may know how we are, and that you may encourage your hearts. And with them, Onesimus, a faithful and beloved brother, who is one of yourselves, they will tell you of everything that has taken place. Aristarchus, my fellow prisoner, greets you, and Mark, the cousin of Barnabas, concerned whom you have received instructions, if he comes to you, receive him. And Jesus, who is called Justus. These are the only men of the circumcision among my fellow workers for the kingdom of God, and they have been a comfort to me. Luke, the beloved physician, and Demas greeted you. Give my greetings to the brethren at Laodicea and the Nymphia at the church in her house. And when this letter has been read among you, have it read also in the church of the Laodiceans, and see that you read also the letter from Laodicea, and say to your keepers, see that you fulfill the ministry which you have received in the Lord. I, Paul, write this greeting with my own hand. Remember my fathers. Grace be with you. Amen.
The 70 returned with joy.
Rejects me, And he who rejects me rejects him who sent me. And this is a beautiful model of that continuation of his love letter. The continuing eternal revelation of who is God, the church. Jesus Christ sends the Holy Spirit. He ordained the 12. The 12 ordained the 70. And to this day we have bishops and priests and our laity. One body, one church, a continuous revelation of God. How do we know this is the question? He who has eyes to see, let him see. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. We have a living, breathing church. We have the Holy Scriptures. We have living, breathing saints today, people who live on earth, and also people alive in the kingdom of heaven today. And I will go to my last question society asks. What about all these other religions? And that is a very good question. How do we know not to worship this religion or that religion? Some of us were born into this religion, but as conscious, self-aware adults, our choice is the same as those who converted into this religion. We are able to choose our religion. And this is one of the beautiful gifts God has given us from the moment he created us. Freedom. Freedom to love him. Freedom to hate him. Freedom to reject him. Freedom to obey him and to say no to him. Religion is a beautiful thing. It has nurtured civilizations to this day. It can be very confusing when one thinks about truth and what is truth. Let us look at our Bible. Our Lord gave the most compelling answer about truth in the Last Supper. Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And Jesus said to him, "I am the way." And this is our answer for us why we follow Jesus. He is our Lord. He said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you should have known my Father also. And from henceforth, you know him and have seen him." From Jesus' mouth, we have these answers. We have seen the Father through him. And he is the way. For the first time in history also, we have a figure, Jesus Christ, explaining that in his personhood, God and man, is found the doorway to salvation, the truth, the bread of life, the life and the resurrection. In all other religions, salvation is found through a set of beliefs, and through following a certain set of actions, not with Christianity. No set of beliefs or actions can save any one of us without the man. God has become man for the first time in history. The God-man, or Theanthropos, is the answer. No one achieves salvation without going through him. He is the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. In today's Gospel, Luke mentions to rejoice, not that you have been given power to cast out demons and to perform miracles and any of those other gifts of the Holy Spirit, but that your names are written in heaven. And I say this to point out the Pantocrator icon. For most churches, it's on the dome in the center of the church, Jesus holding a book. In our church, it's in the back when you walk in. Jesus is holding a book, and many people think this is the gospel. Usually when saints hold a book, it means they've written something. Jesus did not write anything. This is the book of life, and inscribed in this book are the names of all those who will be saved. This is why we come to church, and this is why we follow Jesus. This was always our holy mission, and why we were created. We were fashioned in his own likeness and image to be one with him in communion. That is also why we call receiving his body and blood holy communion. Because he is the head, we are his members, and we receive his body and blood. And when we do this, we become his body and blood. If we had a God that did not reveal himself, if we had a God that did not visit us, that did not save us, if our God was truly something vague and abstract, it would make sense to give different answers to these questions I have posed. But we have a very real and living God, and he has left us a living, breathing church. He has left us with the means to call upon him for our salvation. And fear not, if you still feel you do not know God and you still have doubts. Luke ends today's gospel with, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and understanding and revealed them to babes. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. He says, Nipis. To Nipio is what? Child. Nipiagogio is kindergarten. School of children. He calls us children. So we are children who are learning and are in our infancy when it comes to approaching and understanding our divine God. And Jesus blesses us in this childlike understanding. So for us, it is only proper, and I'll end with this, that we respond with, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Amen.
per ten che non capisce. Sta per ten che è per i mondi, per dire un milano, che ti affronta e che ti offende. Che non sta per i dritti in mezzo che ti strafasse. Che non affronta e su una luce, che ti esonda e ti esonda e ti Che pare che nel fondo non è da dove si scrive e esonda e ti cruce. Tutti a spazzidia, tutti a stepelos. Che sto nema, tu hai, tu chino, tu soppiono, tu tu patrosi, tu economo. Così patrì che i loro si costinumano, che se non ci esonano, che la lista di altri profitono. Ismia, ma via, che tu ti che posso dire chi sia. O mo lo vuoi in parte, ma i sapi si compiono. Lo sto qua a nasco si ne calon. Esoi tu melodos, e omos, amin. I believe in one Father, Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnated. The Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and was suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. In one Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and of the life of the ages to come. Amen.
So. The grave.
bring them to the forefront as we will address them. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning. So today we celebrate Luke the Evangelist, Lucas o Apostolos και Evangelistis. And this, as most of you might know, is the Gospel. And I'm holding it today because Luke was an evangelist. This means he spread the good news. He was there when Jesus walked the earth, and he's a very special saint for us because of him. And he's over here. He's one of these guys. There's four of them: Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Because of these individuals, these friends of Jesus, apostles and disciples, they wrote down everything that they saw Jesus do and everything that they heard happened all around the towns, all the miracles. They wrote it down into this book. And this is the book, the Gospel, which we use every single Sunday. Luke was very special. Luke was, from these four gentlemen, Luke was the most educated. He was a Greek from Antioch, but his parents were originally from Thebes. And some might be from that area who are here in the church today. And he went to school and he got many degrees. He learned the Greek language very well, in which the Gospel was originally written. He also studied philosophy, and he also studied medicine. He's a doctor. They call him Luke, the doctor. And because he's a doctor, he took notice of Jesus' most healing miracles. Like the biggest miracles of Jesus healing the sick, the blind, the deaf, the paralyzed. Luke writes the most of those because he was a doctor. So for us, it's a very special day that we remember Luke. And Luke, he's one of my favorite evangelists. Because of his Greek, his Gospel sounds a little different than the other Gospels. In English, you can't really pick it up, but if one day you read the Greek in Luke's Gospel, it sounds like poetry. It's very beautiful. It is a work of art. And as I said before to the adults, that the Gospel and the entire Bible is a love letter from God to us all. And Luke helped write some of that letter. And Luke's Gospel sounding so pretty and so poetic, like a poem, is a beautiful continuation of that love letter. So that's why he's one of my favorite. So with those words, I ask us to continue praying the Divine Liturgy. God bless you all. And we hope to see the youth on Tuesdays for our Zoom meeting.
Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
because of my unworthiness, or for the cleanliness and sanctification of souls. own body and the pledge of the future life and kingdom. It is good for me to cling to God and to place in Him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not reveal your mysteries to your adversaries, nor will I give you a kiss in the Judas. As a thief, I confess to you, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
For those who have prepared to receive Holy Communion, we will give Holy Communion at the end, after dismissal. Για όσους έχουν προετοιμαστεί να μεταλάβουν τη Θεία Κοινωνία στο τέλος, μετά την απόλυση θα τη δώσουμε, ξεκινώντας από μπροστά. Please join me now as we will chant the Eucharistio for the family of, well, for the loved ones submitted by Catherine Orphan. Small announcement. For the past 35 years, the ladies Filocopos, with the assistance from parishioners, prepared and served a hot dinner in the Salvation Army soup kitchen once a month. Due to COVID restrictions, this arrangement is no longer permitted for those who partake of the meal and those who volunteer. Now those in need of a meal go to the soup kitchen and are given a bag lunch, which contains foods meeting dietary guidelines, and our Filocopos has decided they can safely resume this important ministry. Each month, the bag lunches will be sponsored by an individual in memory of loved ones, and as in the past, Eucharistion service will be chanted for those in whose memory the meal is being served. It'll just be sung and chanted on Sundays. And like I said, for the October Soup Kitchen, lunches are being sponsored by Catherine Orphan.
Φιλάτων αυτάσι στην μακαρία ζωή την πάλαση φιλάνθρωπε. In your place of rest, O Lord, where will your saints repose? Give rest also to the souls of your servants, for you alone are immortal. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You are our God. rescue us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Et de Deo, Messiae, Verum, Abbaus, Eus, Tosticas, Vangitim, Venom, Dulum, Dulum, Theo. Maria, Costadinos, Vasiligi, Costadinos, Marika, Costadinos, Ekaterini, Kathleen, Vasilios, Ioannis, Panagiotas, Stratico, Ellen. Και υπέρ του συγχωρηθήν εαυτόν αυτοίς πάντου ημερημάν πουσιώντε και αγούσιον.
May the Holy Trinity bless and protect us all. Please be seated. morning, everyone. It's so beautiful to be here with you. Just a couple of announcements. Tuesday, we have the youth Zoom meetings for ages 4 to 12. So if anyone knows of any parents out there that have children at that age group, we would love to have them. The meetings are growing every week, so it'll be a pleasure to multiply that ministry. Baragisi service, we will have Bible study Monday nights and book club. We're reading our book Boundaries. It's going very well. At 6:30, we meet here in the church, but there are also Zoom and call-in options for those who want to remain home. You just have to email us for the details, and we'll help you log on. Otherwise, we'll see you at 6:30 tomorrow. Next Monday, we have Divine Liturgy, Orthodox and Divine Liturgy, at 8:30 and 9:30 in the morning for St. Demetrius. My home parish is St. Demetrius in Astoria, so he's a very dear saint to me. Plus, also, he is one of the biggest saints of the church, so it is important that we celebrate these large, great saints. We're starting Greek school soon, both for adults and for the youth. The youth will be completely online and virtual. Adults will be in person. More details will be forthcoming soon. If you've registered, or if you still want to register, or you know someone who's interested, please leave your name and info today with us, and we'll contact you about the details and how to register. In our bulletin, last announcement, we have a mini update for the campaign for St. George. I'm so proud of our community. All of you have stepped up so much. We are over halfway to our goal of $50,000. And please, if you want to donate, please go online. Also pick up our bulletin to see the mini update, but the full update, we have a full web page now that has been created by several individuals, and we're very grateful for everyone's efforts to work toward this campaign. That's all I have for this week. Anything else?
Christmas card.
Philotokos is beginning their drive for the Christmas card.
I have the forms here. If anybody would like to come and sign up, like to study, start a little bit early because I don't get to see everybody like we used to in the coffee hour. So please, I can get a form here. The price this year is $15 because of everything going up.
Please see Gladys to sign up for the Christmas card. And we will now do dismissal. We'll start from the front rows going back, so please be patient. We do not pass around an offering tray during this time of the pandemic. The offering tray is here in the front row to make our offering to the church. Have a blessed week. God bless you all.